With me now, former Bill Clinton advisor Dick Morris. All right, good evening, Dick. You were with the Clintons in the White House for years, and you know how Hillary thinks. If you were advising her, what would you tell her to get her out of this mess? Can she even get out of the mess?
There's no way, Jeanine. This has gone way beyond a mess. This is a disaster, and I don't agree with your previous guest. I think that you are going to see O'Malley do very well in the caucuses and primaries against Hillary.
Tell us about O'Malley. Tell us about him.
He's the former governor of Maryland, a Democratic nominee, as liberal as Hillary on most stuff, that's taking her on in the primaries. And I believe that this latent discontent with Hillary, this concern that these scandals are going to doom the party in November, is going to mount higher and higher. And I would not discount the possibility that a candidate who's nowhere today catches fire and begins to move. We have to understand how this email scandal is a gigantic river with tributaries which will keep us going for months, if not for years.
Well, and you know,
when those
Dick,
30,000 emails come out.
Excuse me, Dick, and there's no question, this is a woman who understands the system. She's got more experience than anyone in government with federal prosecutors and investigations. She did it intentionally, I assume. She lied about the two devices.
Yeah, here's what happened, Jeanine. When Henry Kissinger was Secretary of State, he transcribed with the Secretary every conversation he had with the global leader. At the end of his tenure, he asked the State Department, "Do I have to give these back to you?" And the State Department said, "Yes, you do." So Kissinger didn't want to, and he secreted them in a safe in Vice President Nelson Rockefeller's home. And the Supreme Court ruled that, yeah, you have to give them back, but only the State Department itself can make you do that. So he was safe. And Hillary's figured the same thing. She took office and she said, "I'm not going to sue myself to get these back. I can keep them in a private safe guarded in my house."
All right.
But what she didn't reckon on was that she would be so close to danger in so many of these scandals, and the emails would be so decisive in those, that the demand for them would overwhelm her candidacy, and that's what's happening now.
All right, so you've got this woman who's in, you know, was in hot water in Benghazi, and yet her approval ratings were incredibly high, and now, you know, we've got this latest scandal with people, you know, when you talk about emails, everybody can relate to them. What is she doing? Is she waiting it out? Is she going to announce? What would you be telling her?
She's hoping that it goes away. She's delighted that Elizabeth Warren is not going to challenge her at this point, although if O'Malley does well in the polls, I wouldn't bet on Warren staying out. And she's hoping that this thing just goes away through time. But I think she's missing the point that as she accumulates negatives and as people trust her less and less, and the deadlines loom for other people to get into the race, you're going to have a vacuum here with an irresistible force pushing the Democratic Party to having an alternative to Hillary. Because if she goes down over this scandal, which I think she will, it'll cause enormous losses in 2016. Not just the presidency, but mammoth losses in Congress. And I think the Democrats have to be very worried about that taking place.
All right. Dick Morris, good to see you this evening. Thank you. All right, and coming up, guess who's Saturday Night Live?